Okay, oh, I'll start. Okay, this time I will speak this contents. Richard and Takeyama, thank you for mention to my talk. Sorry. Hello, nice to meet you. I am Shuta Hashimoto. I am member of OpenSUSE Japan User Group. My work in the group is managing events, introducing OpenSUSE at conference. I introduce portals and CUBIC. And most important, my work is to write geek magazine articles. I usually use this icon, Twitter and Facebook and OSEM. Regards. Okay, what is OpenSDS? OpenSDS is abstraction layer of storage to design used by many systems and use many storages. Their goal is open autonomous data platform. Inside using OpenSDS, there are container systems like Kubernetes, Docker, virtualization systems like OpenStack, VMware, and other like Cloud Foundry. This is emphasized in slide. Inside used by OpenSDS, there are two categories. First is storage. This includes LVM, Ceph, Cinder, and more. This is on the left side in slide. Second is Multi Cloud. This includes Amazon S3, Azure Storage, and more. Upper side systems use transparently storage and Multi Cloud storages. Oh, by the way, what is software-defined storage? Usually, when we use storage by the system, system administrator set up all things. Sometimes, system administrator same as system operator or developer. Or he should have many skills and many jobs. He creates volume and attach it to system and adjust total storages. SDS do it automatically. System operator order volume. So system requests that to SDS system, and SDS system do it, creates volume and attach it. This case only includes create and attach, but SDS can do detach, delete, replication, backup, and more. In this workflow, there is one important point. That is how requests. If administrator set up volumes, he can adjust setup each steps. About SDS, system should request definition, and SDS system should publish API for that definition. This model is like infrastructure as code. It is storage as code, if I say. Of course, code is written by not only administrator, but also system itself. Okay, I returned talk to OpenSJS. It became to this outline when I map SJS model to OpenSJS. OpenSJS has northbound plugin project named Sushi. This provides how system join OpenSJS. Sushi provides CSI and service catalog for Kubernetes. Cinder compatible API for OpenStack. This is outside of Sushi. OpenSJS has command line interface and dashboard. Dashboard is web interface. You can log in and manage OpenSJS from dashboard. How about lower side? OpenSJS only defines and implements API. OpenSJS has many drivers that join API to physical things. For example, LVM driver creates logical volume from volume group. This case, administrator only set up volume group. DRBD driver creates host-based replication between two hosts. If you want to append new storage solutions, only you should write driver, but maybe that is a slightly hard work. And OpenSJS have only server program. To use it, only run it. And OpenSJS have driver control program named Doc. Doc manage storage drivers, and controller manage Doc. One case, Cubic use Ceph through CSI. Another case, OpenSUSE use AWS S3 object. Unfortunately, there is no northbound plugin for OpenSUSE, but OpenSJS has command line interface, dashboard, and client program. We can write shell script or client program. Honestly, I say, many storage has manager or is manager. For example, DRBD has rinser, and OpenStack can manage volumes itself. And before session talk, look is also. About this point, OpenSJS has no advantage. Rinser can manage DRBD more effectively than OpenSJS. The one of OpenSJS advantage is to manage multiple storages and used by multiple systems. OpenSJS has a design outline on their GitHub. Please see that to know details. Let's see functions. About storage, OpenSJS can create volumes, attach volumes, snapshot, replication, and delete. About multi-cloud, use bucket and migration. Each function only do one thing, that is small power. But OpenSJS aims autonomous data platform, that means each function cooperate each other. I tell one scenario. System requests volume. OpenSJS create volume and replicate. Every day, get snapshot. And after month, system does not need data. OpenSJS move that to cold tape, cold storage like tape. Not tape drives has not implemented yet. About multi-cloud, OpenSJS implements migration. You can migrate data from AWS S3 to Azure Storage. About OpenSJS, development is going on. start is that, 0. So, A, Alba. B, Bali. Oh, Bali is host of Open Source Asia Summit in this year. And C, Capri is now developing. Capri feature being managed to master of OpenSAS GitHub. There are many notable features, especially data lifecycle. Data lifecycle manage object lifecycle. To define term, AWS S3 objects migrate to Azure storage after that term, and finally delete it. If data have lifecycle like log, you can map it to storage. This is the future of OpenSDS. Many companies join OpenSDS as user and establish user group name and user advisory committee. They do not advise user, they advise developer. They request their want and need. Held meeting by week. This project grow depend on user demand, same as other open source projects. Okay, changing the topic. I talk container volume strategy. First, I talk about Docker. This picture is drawn container recreate. You know, container is virtualization system. Container contains all things. But that means container also has data. Container has one advantage, that is, you can recreate container from image anytime. Recreated container is same as before, because it created from same image. Image don't have data, so container also don't have data. We resolve this dilemma to write data outside of container. One is mount host path, or two is use data volume container. Our data volume container is container, so it has same theme. Usually, we plan backup to safety place. When we design container storage strategy about Docker and Kubernetes, most important thing is to determine which data need to be outside of container. In other words, which data need to be persistent. It is necessary to know container structure so that we know it. Which data does not change from image? Which data changes from image in operation? Which data changes from image is clue of which data needs persistent. And if we can, we should express which data is changing in operation when we create container images. OK, cubic and volumes. About cubic, pod runs independent nodes. So pod cannot use nodes except defining node affinity. Upper side of this slide is independent nodes. For lower side of this slide is dependent physical like nodes. So to join pod to volume, volume should be network volume. This item in slide express Kubernetes resources except storage most lower item and admin, which is human. To use this mechanism, pod should have persistent volume claim name to use and mount point in pod. Persistent volume claim define what want. For example, volume type, capacity, and access mode. Type is storage class, which is second from bottom, resources. Persistent volume is express volume to use. This defines type, capacity, and access mode, which is same as persistent volume claim. Further, storage data like API IP. Last is storage class. This is category of storage. Category is defined by administrator arbitrarily, not storage demands. For example, high speed and low speed. To say policy, this definition is called profile. Some storage systems include OpenSDS. Kubernetes has two ways to provision volume. One is left side. This is handmade by administrator. Administrator writes YAML for persistent volume. Kubernetes attaches persistent volume to persistent volume claim automatically. Kubernetes finds satisfying a demand persistent volume. Define of storage data like API IP in persistent volume is used by this case. Two is right side. This is dynamic provisioning. To create persistent volume claim, persistent volume is created by Kubernetes automatically. This model like software-defined storages. To use this, we need to define provisioner in storage class. Provisioner create persistent volume and attach pod automatically. Kubernetes has many provisioner of major storages like GCE persistent disk, Cinder. Further, Kubernetes supports CSI, which is Common Storage Interface. CSI can append other storage provisioner and can use same way in this dynamic provisioning. I say simply, CSI need to run node plugin pod and controller plugin pod, two pods. So to define provisioner in storage class, we can use this append provisioner. The one way that OpenSDS supports Kubernetes is CSI. This is released and recommended. And now, this is the only way to OpenSDS used by Kubernetes, by Cubic. Okay, I tell features. This is the alpha features. Kubernetes implements service catalog, which is implementation of mechanism to use Open Service Broker. Open Service Broker is API of Service Broker. So, what is Service Broker? Service Broker is solution of Cloud Foundry to use other managed service. Service Broker join Cloud Foundry to other managed service like RDS. Developer implements Open Service Broker as Cluster Service Broker. Service Catalog in Kubernetes use Cluster Service Broker. Cluster Service Broker mediate between Kubernetes and managed services. I tell workflow to use Service Catalog. First, administrator gets list from Cluster Service Broker. Cluster Service Broker shows list of service served from managed service. This list represents in Kubernetes as cluster service class and cluster service plan. Cluster service class is type of service like volume. Cluster service plan is plan of service like free tier or paid tier. This time, there is no instance anywhere, only get list. Second, use managed service for pod. This step has two Kubernetes resources. One is service instance. This is represent service. Two is service binding. This is represent bindings of pod and service instances. Administrator selects cluster service class and cluster service plan for pod and creates service instance defines that plans. This step creates managed service instance. So, administrator creates service binding for pod. This step creates secrets, includes binding information. Secrets is one of Kubernetes resources. This defined subject is different each managed services. Last, administrator creates pod defined secrets service binding made. In this model, administrator need create service instance and service binding. And administrator tell operator service binding information to need pod. Operator creates pod with reference to the information. I tell this in talk of Cubic and OpenSDS, but workflow is same as a managed service. So, OpenSDS develops service broker. Now, this is alpha. Outline is same as other service brokers I explained. Managed service is OpenSDS, and cluster service broker develops OpenSDS mediated between Kubic and OpenSDS. Service class that cluster service broker show is volume service. Yes, OpenSDS is solution of volume. Service plan that cluster service broker show is default, replication, and more. Administrator creates service instance with to set service class and service plan. And creates service binding with to set service instance. Service binding creates secret includes binding information, which includes volume ID. Now, I talk about one new feature of Kubernetes that's named pod preset. This is also alpha. This is injection additional runtime requirements into a pod at creation time. Pod preset defines injection data. When pod creates, pod injected that data. Level selector mediate between pod preset and pod. This case, pod preset define volume and volume mounts, and define match levels. Operator only creates pod include level match the match levels in pod preset. Pod preset needs volume ID that defines service binding. And use flex volume plugin to join volume. To use flex volume is a bad idea, many people think. So this should be changed. This model, administrator creates service instance, service binding, and pod preset. And tell operator label name, which is match pod preset. Operator only define label name that tells by administrator. Cluster service broker OpenSDS developed will improve, so Cubic can use OpenSDS effectively through service catalog. Okay, finally, I speak packaging status. Oh, unfortunately, all distributions do not remark OpenSDS. But yesterday, an OpenSDS member told me that SALT is ready. But this is only for OpenSUSE, not Cubic, not MicroOS. Other way, we have to compile to use OpenSDS in OpenSUSE. In fact, OpenSDS is newer solution, unstable and too complex. But OpenSDS has potential. I think there is worth to package it. I want somebody to package it. Or if nobody it, maybe I will try to package it. Please help me if I do. And there is one notable point. OpenSDS tutorial wiki has text that we recommended use Ubuntu strongly. I tell them that I do that tutorial as OpenSUSE. They rejoice that. I want to modify that text to Ubuntu and OpenSUSE strongly. Okay. I will express experience to use OpenSDS. Please remark it and use OpenSDS with Cubic. Thank you. That's all my presentation. I have Q&A time, but sorry, I'm not good at English. Please ask slowly. Any questions? OK, I finished my talk. Thank you.